Hey guys, I wanted to show you that trick that you can do in theater on the new Zombies map that will remove objects that are interactable or that are animated or things that are part of Easter eggs. So if you see something on the map and you're like, could this be part of an Easter egg? You could do this trick and it might help you out. There is a method for doing this theater trick on Shadows of Evil and the Giant, but that method doesn't seem to be working on this map, but I did find something that does work. This method does work for me every time. I don't know if it will work for other people, but I wanted to show you guys how to do it. So you have to go into theater and you need to find a game that's over 100 minutes long. I have about 3 or 4 games that are well over 100 minutes, but every time I would try to load it, it would error out and send me back to like the home screen and kick me out of the game. So the trick is to find a game that is over 100 minutes long that will actually load and you can go into it and see it. I've had to use people on my friends list to go into their theater to find some games, and I actually finally found one. To get into your friends' games, all you have to do is go into theater and then hit triangle and it's gonna pull up your friends list. Click on one of their names and you're gonna see the option for showcase, so click on that and then go all the way down to recent games and it'll show everything that they've been playing recently. I did find a game that was over 100 minutes inside of Jag's theater, so big shout out to him. He doesn't even know I was sneaking into his theater, but yeah, this one actually loaded for me and it didn't error out, so I knew it would work. So once the game actually loads and you see the players inside of it, what you want to do is hit triangle on your controller and that's going to change the camera. It's going to release you from that player. You're going to be in like free camera mode at that point. Next thing you want to do is hover over that fast forward button and click that thing so it is maxed out, that it is fast forwarding times 6. Let it fast forward so that it goes past the 2-minute mark in the game, just at least there. It can go a little bit further, that's fine. Then hover over the pause button and get ready to pause it. Once you pause it, you want to push down on your left analog stick to toggle off the controls so there's nothing on the screen. Then spam the hell out of the left trigger, like the L2, so that you go backwards in time. So you're like skipping backwards to the beginning of the game. You would do it very, very quickly. And if you do it right, then like everything on the map is going to disappear like this. All the doors will be gone. All this stuff right here that was floating is gone. You're going to see like the perk machine is missing. There's a skull that was for the Easter egg on one of the bows, that's gone. And then if you go over here, it looks really crazy. Like this was a part of the purple bow and yeah, you had to do something up there. So there was some kind of trigger. So that is gonna be totally gone. If you go up into the bell tower, there's an Easter egg step up here and the back of this clock is gone. This is usually a wall. So you can see, yeah, all of this is interactable right here. If you wanna put everything back together, then all you have to do is just hit play and everything that should be there will come back and then you can really start to see like what is standing out, what is interactable, what could be part of an Easter egg. Another thing I wanted to show y'all is how to get out of the map. So go into theater mode, go into free camera where you can just like fly around, go on top of this roof, you're gonna go down here, then look up and you go up against this brick wall, look down again, you should be able to get underneath the map. I think this is really cool because you can actually see that final battle room of the Easter egg step. You can also see that room that you teleport to where you're like back in time and it's black and white. Also underneath the map, you can see the exploded moon. Like that graphic like gets replaced and goes up into the sky, but they've got it like hidden underneath the map. So you can see all that stuff. Yeah, like right here, that is the black and white room that you go into, that you teleport into. And then over to the left, it's really far out, but you can see like, yeah, that's the big boss fight, that room right there. So that's really cool just to know kind of where it is on the map. I don't know if we're gonna find any secrets under here. I just thought this looked really awesome, but I hope you guys enjoyed this and we'll see you next video.